Hi, some of you have asked about using a harp cart to carry your harp with. This is something I've used for many years, and I thought you might like it. Here it goes.
You can hear my harp singing in the background. That's nice, and you'll also hear some folks that are doing some work in the condo next door there. So I'm going to show you the harp carrier. It's funky, okay? I've had it several years, and it served me really well. And this is what it looks like when it's opened up. Sometimes in my journey, I've used this part as a flute holder or my music stand legs part, and there is this here to tie it up on top. Sometimes I'll do that if I'm, you know, carrying, like I said, I like to make as little trips as possible for my gig, so it depends on what I'm carrying. It opens like this. I can put in my music stand here. Or if I'm using a big fancy wooden one, I don't put it in there, I carry that by hand. But I've taken to making things as easy for myself as possible. This being the stand for the music stand, and that can fit in there as well. Sometimes this is all I need for my gig bag. It's got the extra strings, tuners, iPad, phone, all of that. And I can just put that right in. I think I'm going to show you how that packs. So this is what, you know, the bag inside is, my gig bag and the music stand, and it closes up very easily. It locks closed. If I have more stuff in there, and it won't lock closed, so you know, locking, it's not really locked, but it just holds itself closed at that position. But if I have too much stuff in there, I can just wrap that around, and depending on how tight it is, I can support it. Well, I can't do it with one hand. Okay. Don't worry about that. Here we go. I'm going to show you the harp in the cart now. Okay, so just pick it up and slip it in there. And you have it in there. Now I have these, the way that this harp is that this has a sort of a floor to it, and that actually keeps it from tipping. It just happens that this harp has it that way. Another thing I also do, if I'm going to be on bumpy terrain, I'll put this mat in here behind the harp, so that any bumping is not. Now, I don't have to strap it. It stays in there because of that flooring that I told you about. So that's very handy. Now, sometimes I'll put the cover on, like if it's raining, and I've just made a flat cover, but just a fabric cover. Sometimes I'll also put the harp cover, which is like a heavy fleece. I'll put that right behind the harp so that any metal part is not rubbing against it. I can be pretty laid back about that stuff, and some of you may not be as comfortable about putting your harp right on the cart. But the way I remedy that when I feel like it's an issue is to put the harp cover, the soft fleece harp cover, over any metal of the harp cart, and so that it's sitting there nice and comfortably. Then I also have in here a box that I built hundreds of years ago, it seems like. It's a box that I built maybe 20 years ago. Please excuse my housekeeping. I've been so busy doing my gigs. But anyhow, so then I just take it and slide it into the box. And put these pillows in here. And I can push them all the way to the top. And the harp is very protected. There. Voila. Like I said, excuse my housekeeping, but harpists have other things to do. So the actual pillows this time, if I was actually going to be packing and going, I would move the pillows further up as well to give it more padding.
Up top, because that's the hottest part. And then I've got this, which is a fabric cover that I keep in the car in case I want to use it for the harp, or unless I want to give it some extra padding this way. So there you have it. Okie dokie. Like I said, please excuse my housekeeping, but the car is handy.
It served me really well. And it's got the extra wide wheels. It's not great for going on the beach, but it, you know, I just hold it at more of an angle, and that helps. I don't go on the beach with it very often. I also have this other bag that sometimes I use for certain gigs, and it takes more space, but there's still room back there. So when I'm using this bag here is when I'm doing like assisted living facilities. It's got some more equipment in it. I still have room to do that.
And then I'll put the cover on again.
And I can still use the handle to prop the bag on there. I just have to be careful that it doesn't tip over, so I have to have it low enough. And then I can still put the harp in. So it really is handy. I'd love to spread the word on using these. They run about $90 now. There's different brands. And like I said, I've used so many of these over the last 30 years. Thing I'd like to point out that's good to think about if you're picking one of these out, make sure that there are four sets of wheels. There'll be two big round ones at the back, wider than this, and then in the front there'll be two sets of two wheels. As you see here, there's four wheels in the front, smaller than the back ones. I hope this helps.
It's more than a harp cart. It's, you know, you got your whole gear in there. And if I need to make more than one trip, I can. I can empty it, or I can just carry the other. My sound system is on wheels, so that makes that easier. So usually if I'm going to do two trips, I'll do what I can on this, and then I'll go back and get the sound system. And that way the harp is in the car the least amount of time. So I hope this helps you make your decision on how you're going to move your harp around on rough terrain or even easy terrain. It just makes life easier. It's bulky. It does take up, you know, a bit of room in the car, but it's definitely worth it. And it's sort of soft in the sense of, you know, it does take room in the car, but it's not like it's a big hard metal. It is metal, but with a lot of fabric to it. It's pretty soft. Okay, bye.